Tonight, a local electrician says someone stole his trailer full of tools that cost around $20,000. He also says he knows where it is, but can't get it. He's asking Minneapolis police and the city for help because it's his livelihood. But as Jennifer Hoff reports, he's facing hurdles.
Jerry Yang has worked as an electrician for 12 years, recently starting his own business.
I love just the trades itself.
That's him with his marked truck and black trailer that he discovered was missing on Monday.
I got to the job site around 6:30 in the morning, and the trailer is gone, and my heart just basically dropped.
Stolen, he said, from outside a job site in North Minneapolis, only to find it again a half mile away. He was led to what's called the Near North Homeless Encampment, where he took this picture thanks to a tracking device he installed in it. But even after filing a report, he says Minneapolis police can't get the trailer back just yet.
Well, they warn you not to go into it, basically saying that, you know, it's a, you know, a high crime area. I wish they can just, like, put a little more pressure on it.
The camp sits on city property and has been around a couple years. Leaders tried to evict people in the past, a police spokesperson saying officers were attacked. Now a new eviction notice is posted from last month.
The criminals there only know that, you know, they can walk away and do whatever they want and know that the cops are not going to, you know, enforce the law in that area. It just makes me feel helpless and people in the community feel helpless.
That same spokesperson saying they are willing to help Yang, waiting to find the right time and circumstances, adding they have to get creative to get the job done with the least amount of force. Police and Yang recognizing the risk right now may be too much.
Even though I was to retrieve it back, I'm pretty sure everything is gone. Wait and see. That's all we can do.
Police also admit that this is just not a perfect solution or situation at that, and say that they are working to clear out that encampment, but also have to follow certain requirements, and that includes making resources available to the people who are staying there. This is all while Yang is hopeful that the insurance that he does have, Julie, will hopefully cover all of his losses. But even that right now is up in the air.
Yeah, it's hard to imagine how frustrating that would be, knowing where it is, knowing the police know where it is, and everybody saying there's just nothing we can do about it right now.
Right.
Thanks, Jennifer. Yep.